Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam sacrificed a lot, yet he was known as Khalilullah, the friend of Allah. Allah has proven to us that closeness to Allah has nothing to do with how famous you are, how popular you are, how powerful you are, how much wealth you have, how much strength you have, what your looks are like or your body, etc. Allah Almighty has proven that to us by sending the most beloved unto him, his friends, and a chain of messengers, and all of them went through struggles. And he says to us through the blessed lips of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that the prophets of his are the first ones who go through hardship and trial from their own people and various other sources, and then the rest who are closer to them and closer, and so on and so forth. So the closer you are to Allah, the more challenges you will face in your life. The closer you are to Allah, the more people will make your life difficult, because Allah wants you to trust him fully. Let's go back to this history very briefly today. We still have a few weeks to talk about this, inshallah. And the Hajj will probably be in the second week of July, this particular year, 2022. So, remember Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, when he was young, he grew up in a home that was not Muslim. But he always searched for the one deity who made him, because he always knew deep down that the only one worthy of being worshipped is the one who made me, no one else, nothing else. And so he looked at the stars, he looked at the moon, he looked at the sun, he looked at other creatures of Allah Almighty, but he refused. He said, no, man, these things, they are there, then they disappear, they are big, and then they become small and they are not there. The sun is huge and then it goes away. He says, no way. Don't be mistaken, he never ever worshipped them. He only considered and contemplated. That's what happened. But he didn't worship these creatures. He continued further and further until he says, وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. I have turned my face in dedication, in worship, in submission to the one who has created the heavens and the earth. And I will not be from among those who associates partners with him. Allah loved that so much. Are you serious? Subhanallah. Are you serious in that statement that you will only worship the one who made you? Are you serious that you will only worship he who made the heavens and the earth? Call him the maker, the creator, the nourisher, the cherisher, the one in absolute control of every aspect of your existence and mine and entire existence. Are you sure he is the only one you're going to worship? If the answer is yes, well, we have to test you, because Allah says, أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. Do people think it's okay and enough to just say we're believers and then they're not tested regarding that belief? Allah says, we tested those before you in order to distinguish those who are truthful and those who are not. So what does Allah do? Allah Almighty begins to put in your path trials, tests. And each time there is a trial, what does it do? If you're a believer, it draws you closer to Allah. And you lay your trust in Allah and your conviction in Allah. How many problems have you and I been through in our lives? Say, for example, how old are you? You might be 20, 30, 50. The older you are, the more challenges you've had. You might have had such massive challenges in your life where at that time you thought, I'm not going to come out of this. And today you're sitting like a king. Subhanallah. Am I right or wrong? There were times in your life when you probably thought, I'm so ill and sick, I'm not going to make it. And today you're healthy, as fit as a fiddle. Subhanallah. There were times in your life when perhaps you might have had a business disaster where you thought, I don't know how I'm going to come out of this. And today you have 20, 30 people working for you, if not more. Has it not happened? So Allah shows you, hang on, the days are owned by us. Were they not days when things disappeared from you, when you lost everything you had perhaps? And Allah says, you're still alive. You have clothing. You have a plate of food. You're okay. You're surviving.